Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Boy, I hope somebody out there appreciates the research that I did about this magnitude 6.3 earthquake that occurred in central Greece. Yeah, I've been spending all morning trying to find out what fault zone it happened on because, according to the news reports, it is an unknown fault zone where this occurred, and that is not true. 132 people reported feeling this earthquake, and I'm sure there is some damage. It was right along the Rimino, R-I-M-I-N-O fault. There's the fault zone. And there's been multiple earthquakes within this area, which is along another fault, which is Radia fault, R-O-I-A. I'm probably pronouncing them all wrong. But anyways, yeah, these are known fault zones in this area. And the reason for these earthquakes is because of the extension of the Aegean Sea. And over here, we got the North Aegean Trough. Yeah, it's extending and putting pressure on this area as it extends, grows in length. Historically, there hasn't been a magnitude 7.0 or greater earthquake in this location, actually anywhere in this area, but that doesn't mean a larger earthquake than a magnitude 7.0 can't happen. Geologists, or at least some geologists, have known for about 50 years that because of this extension and crustal deformation, a large earthquake is coming. Here is a research paper published in 2002, which states accelerating deformation, which started 3 decades ago and has been released by a generation of intermediate magnitude of 4.5 earthquakes, is still occurring. Based on these observations, we can assume that this region is now in a state of pre-shock deformation that will lead to a critical point, main shock, a main, very large earthquake. There is another fault, which is much larger, up towards the north, Serbia. And as you know, the longer the fault, the greater the earthquake could occur there. I'm rather excited about the information that I found. EMSC has 63 earthquakes listed for Greece since this magnitude 6.3. And I'm just going to bring it down here real quick so you can see them all. Whereas USGS only lists a couple. In fact, only 8. The most recent being a 5.1. There's a 5.3, a 5.1, and then the initial 6.3. And I keep talking about how the continents are on the move as the Earth magnetic field weakens. Yeah, earthquakes are going to continue and the continents are going to continue to move around. Here we got the North Aegean Trough. Like I said, the Aegean Sea is slowly growing and extending. And these red lines are the different fault zones for the North Anatolia fault system. And then up over here, eons ago, this was what was once the Tethys Ocean, which is now closed up. In this location, this little strait along here, this is where it all closed up by the continents colliding. And I drew that out in yellow. It's a huge area that collided and closed off, which is now the Black Sea, which was once a huge ocean eons ago. But as the continents continue to move, we got the movement of the North Anatolian Fault, which is going westward. And then we got the North Aegean Trough and its extension as it wants to grow, going up to the location of where these earthquakes occurred today. Central Greece really doesn't have much of a history of large earthquakes. Do you see anything on there? No. Most of the large earthquakes are down south. And I went about putting up some of the earthquakes. 2014, there was a 6.0. 2018, a 6.8. 6.7 in 2008. 6.9. A lot of people were injured and a lot of property damaged from a 2014 6.9. But up here in central Greece, yeah, these large earthquakes, yeah, are next to null. But some geologists know that there is a magnitude 7.0 earthquake or greater coming within the next few years. That information should be put out so people can prepare. Might save a few lives. Damage, you know, maybe they can mitigate the damage. Like I said, I hope someone out there appreciates all the work that I did to find out just exactly what is going on and why this occurred there. So if you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you for watching. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.